I wanted to ask you about the horses, the top contenders right now, because I'm trying to put my list together as we go along here, and the three that I had a couple of weeks ago, the last time we talked about this, I had Dornoch, Sierra Leone, and Track Phantom. Those are like the three main ones that only we've covered. So obviously, after last week, Sierra Leone and Track Phantom stay the same. But should I be adding any other horses right now to a top Derby contender list? Or is it too early?
I mean, look, we're running out of time now, right?
I know, right?
We're almost into March, and the Derby's in May, right? The first Saturday in May. We're still going to see a lot of running next in Florida in the Fountain of Youth. You're going to see the debut of Dornoch, the three-year-old debut of Dornoch.
Okay,
I don't think
cool.
you can write off Fierceness yet. I mean, obviously, as bad as he – not bad, but, you know, Fierceness, he needs to he's still shown that he can be brilliant. So he goes to the Florida Derby next. So we'll see what happens with him. It's just there's a lot of moving parts. For me, and I'll beat the drum on this because I don't – And again, I don't know where he runs back. I think he needs to run back. I mean, soon he's breezed twice since the race, and he's still a maiden. And everyone's going to tell me that I'm absolutely insane because he's still a maiden. But in my opinion, the best 3-year old of this crop right now is still a claimed Victor. And we'll see what happens with him when he runs back next time. He needs to break his maiden, and then he needs to take a swing. You know, probably at a race like the Wood Memorial would be my guess or something like that. But a claimed Victor is going to be my top Derby pick right now. Even with no points, it's still a maiden. Nobody ran a more impressive race to me than what he ran in that debut at Tampa back in January. So I'm really looking forward to him. The future is bright. We gave out the allowance winner for Todd at Fairgrounds that basically ran a match race with Nash. He's okay. Look for him to probably run back in the Arkansas Derby. In the Louisiana Derby, I'm sorry. The other horse that we need to talk about here, and he's going to run in the Gotham next week, is a Brad Cox horse named Just a Touch, son of Justify, won on debut, first time out. Looks to be maybe, I know the barn's high on Timberlake, but this might be their best Derby shot. Just ran the one time. He's a $300,000 two-year-old in training purchase for Qatar Racing and Mark Dedevelt. And I feel like he's one that if he wins the Gotham next time out, his trajectory skyrockets. And he's a horse that a lot of people don't know about yet because he just ran the one race at Fairgrounds. He's by Justify that won the Triple Crown. Again, Justify had only had 3 or 4 starts before he won the Kentucky Derby. And there's an interview in the Racing Post in England the other day with trainer Aidan O'Brien, who's widely regarded as one of the best trainers worldwide.
Yep.
He trains for more in Europe. And he's trained so many good horses. And he said in the interview that he thinks, in his opinion, Justify will end up being the greatest stallion of all time.
Wow.
So, I mean, those are big words from a guy who isn't really this boisterous, outgoing, open person. He's normally very well reserved, keeps his cards close to his vest. And he came out and said that he thinks Justify is going to be a game-changing stallion. Maybe Just a Touch is an example of that here in America. Of continuing to parlay that. Don't forget his daughter, just FYI, currently the favorite in the Kentucky Oaks. She won the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. Look for her to debut here probably Saturday in the Devona Dale, would be my guess, at Gulfstream. So a lot of good things looking forward with the 3-year-olds. But those are two horses that nobody's talking about right now that I think they haven't run in a stake yet. I mean, a claimed Victor hasn't won a race yet. But a claimed Victor and Just a Touch are my top two horses right now that nobody knows about.
And Just a Touch is running in the Gotham next week.
Just a Touch is scheduled to run in the Gotham. I would imagine we'd look to see a claimed Victor running very, very soon. He's breezed twice back-to-back since the last race at Tampa. I would look for him to be in the entries any day now.
And a claimed Victor has one race?
One race, 1 second.
And Just a Touch?
One race, one win.
Okay. All right. I love it.
These are some of the lighter raced horses, but they're horses that, you know, just kind of very, very, very high up.
Excellent. Appreciate it, Chad. I know we don't get an opportunity to talk like we used to, but we'll have to change that because we are getting now seriously on the trail. So maybe sometime. Because when are you scheduled to return?
Next Sunday. We'll run Clapton on Saturday. We'll watch the Saudi Cup with great interest as a lot of those horses will move on to the Dubai. It's a grade two here at the track where the Dubai World Cup will be. It's a $500,000 race. And look, we've come to the Middle East with a plan. Didn't win the first race, but we're happy with how we ran. Really feel like he's moved forward greatly off of that race. This will be a big race with us. Everyone's talking about how good the Russian horse was that beat us last time. But you know, in the movie, was it Rocky IV, right?
I mean, against the Russian.
Ivan Drago, he takes out some of the competition, but at the end of the movie, it's Rocky standing tall and being saluted. So we're hopeful that even though maybe we lost the first round, we'll end up with a TKO on next Saturday.
I like it. We'll definitely come make sure if that happens, we'll come with the whole Rocky IV clips ready to go there. So, but that's next Saturday. So that means, so scheduling our show might be difficult next week then?
It'll be the same. I think we'll be the same thing.
Okay.
We'll be okay.
All right.
Same thing, and then I'll be back in America the
following. After that. All right. So, again, next week's going to be big. So that's really the first biggest Kentucky Derby weekend, even though we had that show, you and I, a few weeks ago when we had 5 3-year-old races to talk about. But – this is getting better now because we're talking about, again, the Gotham.
Well, I think, look, the one thing that we saw last week, though, was Sierra Leone has now put himself in the driver's seat.
Yep.
Okay. Here's the line of demarcation. You have to run better than me. I'm the best of the crop right now. He had shown it running so well against the Bias and the Remsen. But again, he had only run twice as a 2-year-old, ran once now as a 3-year-old. Here's who you have to beat. We hadn't seen that yet, other than obviously Baffert's horse with Nysos, who right now is ineligible. The other horses, they've been good but not great. Sierra Leone did things that good horses, that Derby winning horses are supposed to do.
Yep.
Now we move forward to this prep race here at Oaklawn, and it's okay, now it's your turn, right? And you continue to see as these races continue and as these races develop. Is there anybody on Sierra Leone's level yet? And again, the thing about the Kentucky Derby is it doesn't matter because it's not necessarily the best horse. It's the best horse on that day. It's not the best horse that wins. It's almost like, and I always equate these things to like these conference tournament titles and everything else with the in-season to March Madness. Because I would say that maybe 40% of the time, the best team wins the college basketball.
True. Team. Yeah.
And in horse racing, I would say 30% of the time, the best horse wins the Kentucky Derby.
Yep.
And that's why, even though it's the race that everybody wants to win, and obviously the NCAA tournament is the thing that everybody wants to win, but it doesn't take away from the rest of your season, it doesn't take away from the rest of your year. The Breeders' Cup, to me, it's an end-of-the-year thing. You had to prepare your horse all year long to get there.
Yeah.
It's a little bit of a smaller, more concise field. Here, I mean, such a big field.
Yeah, it's crazy. You got to break good. Yeah.
Post is important. You know, there's a lot of moving factors. But right now, when we look ahead to the Kentucky Derby the first Saturday in May, here's Sierra Leone. He's in the Derby. He's established himself as the horse to beat. You know, for a guy in Chad Brown who's always been known as the turf trainer, but it doesn't take away from he's had a lot of success with dirt horses that get overlooked. And I'm sure he would love nothing more than to add to his resume a Kentucky Derby win. It's why you wake up every morning. You know, it's funny because guys like Chad Brown, who are inundated with top horses, every year they come in or every month they come in and have a new batch of cool horses. But the Derby's what gets you up in the morning time. The chance of going to the stable and saying, "Hey, I got the horse to beat for the Kentucky Derby." It just puts an extra pep in your step. It adds to the whole state, the morale of the stable, which look, when you work as hard as we work on the day in, day out basis, you need that. You know, look, a win will pick you up. A stake win, you beat your chest. but a Derby favorite or having the Kentucky Derby, winning the Kentucky Derby, that lasts, that high lasts for at least 363 days until the next. Jack it over to somebody else. And once you win it, it drives you to want to win it again. That's the competitive nature in us. That's why we do this for. But Chad Brown, right now, he holds the card. He has the Willy Wonka trip to the candy factory, to the chocolate factory, and look at all eyes are on him now, right? Every work that horse does, every move that horse makes,
yeah.
You know, you're very much in the spotlight now. You're not coming in under the radar, right? So every and now you get the media requests that start filtering in more so than normal, especially with this time of the year. Everybody wants to know because he is now unquestionably the leader in the clubhouse until. Again, Saturday, maybe there's a new one. But right now, it's Sierra Leone.
Yeah, I'm just popping up on the screen now. The I guess they had a futures wagers pool 4. So okay. Sierra Leone, as you can see there, 6-1.
But you see here, this was the whole thing. The favorite was all other three-year-olds. So the horses that weren't that are unknown, the horses that I'm talking about, the acclaimed victors and just the touches, the Bob Baffert horses, if somehow something changes or they're allowed in the race, you got them at 5-1. You have a load of horses at 5-1. But you're close enough, you're far enough now around where some of these horses should be a little bit more serious. And you're having Sierra Leone 6-1. Door Knock Unraced is a three-year-old at 9-1. Timberlake Unraced this year at 15-1. But the fact that Timberlake got that kind of support – that to me screams that they think he's ready to run in this race at Oakland on Saturday.
All right, and we'll talk more about this. By the way, what are all these horses here? Starting with
Gate Road was a good second in the Sam F. Davis last time, and is you know running out. Amante Bianco, I don't know why he's on there. Born Noble was second the allowance race. I would expect we might see him in the Fountain of Youth next time. Capital Idea was a really, really impressive maiden winner for Christophe Clement. Not sure where we see him back. Maybe he goes back to New York for the Gotham. Maybe he goes to Florida. Maybe he goes to Tampa Bay Derby. Kind of wide open over there. Catching Freedom was third in that race last time out. Deterministic is a horse that needs to get better. Dymatic at 99-1. That's my top pick there.
Yeah.
You know, so certainly, you know, he's unknown. Domestic Product was a good third. Or second, I'm sorry, he was second behind Hades last time out in the Holy Bull. El Grande O is the 99-1 shot, but he was second beating a nose last time out of the mile and eighth Withers. He has that he's gone that distance. Epic Ride, it's a really cool horse. 2-for-3 lifetime, Turfway Park. We looked for him in the Jeff Ruby Stakes next time out. He's one that's an interesting horse I try to buy that they wouldn't sell me. Fierceness, obviously, 16-1 is fair odds.
Yeah,
Fierceness is a horse that, you know, if Fierceness comes back in the Florida Derby and wins by 5, he's 5-1 in the Kentucky Derby.
Yes.
So Fierceness is one that you're rewarded at 16-1.
That's right.
Forever Young, that's the horse we talked about in Saudi. He's the Japanese contender, has no points. We'll have one swing at the iron running in the Kentucky Derby by going through Dubai. So that's kind of. Low odds for the risk that's involved. Hades, look, he's a son of Awesome Slew, did nothing wrong. He took the race to Fierceness. He put Fierceness away, and you get rewarded still twice the odds. I'm hoping he runs back next week in the Fountain of Youth. I didn't want to wait and see him just in the Florida Derby. He needs more racing experience, but he's a nice horse. Hall of Fame, really disappointed last week. Really, really disappointed. Honor Marie ran a sneaky good race. I was okay with that. Imperial Gun and Just Steel. Well, Just Steel we talked about. There's Just a Touch. That's the horse we talked about that
yes.
Just ran the one time. He was a horse in there, 27-1. So certainly well supported. Knightsbridge is a horse that he was a maiden winner last time, needs to keep getting better. Lat Long broke his maiden for Kenny McPeak. Interested to see where he goes next. Liberal Arts, 57-1 on a horse who ran a sneaky good race last time out in the Southwest.
Yep.
He's because that race was delayed, because trainer Robbie Medina prefers to train him in Kentucky at his main string. He has a string at Oaklawn, but he's at the Thoroughbred Center. He's going to elect to keep him in Kentucky where he's been kind of home. So they're going to wait and go fresh for the Arkansas Derby. But 57-1 is Nice odds over there. Locked 16-1. He's back on the work tab. He runs next in the Fountain of Youth for Todd Pletcher. Lucky Jeremy, disappointed. Ran third in the Sunland Derby on Sunday. Ran okay. It'll be interesting to see where Bill Morey elects to send him next. Mystic Dan, 21-1. Certainly fair odds. The winner of the Southwest last time goes to the Arkansas Derby if he can back that up. Nash, disappointed. Wow. Three races in a row. He ran second. He was at one time the horse.
Yeah.
For Brad Cox. He's now kind of slid down the mantle a little bit. No more time. 99-1. No respect there for the Sam F. Davis winner for young trainer Jose D'Angelo. We'll see him next in the Tampa Bay Derby. Real Man Violin was kind of a no-show last week for Kenny McPeak. Resilience, I'll tell you what, Resilience at 83-1 is certainly fair odds because he was fourth last week at Fairgrounds. A little bit of a trouble, did a lot of the Derby work, battled through to the wire. I didn't think he ran a bad race. And if you get 6-1 on Sierra Leone, I don't think that Resilience is 8 times worse than he is or 10 times worse than he is. So I think that's fair odds right now on Resilience. Sierra Leone, we talked about. Speakeasy, he's one that I want to see more of. Stronghold, he was the winner of the Sunland Derby. It was a 20 points to the winner for Phil D'Amato. Ran a good race with Antonio Frezu. Look for him next in a prep race in California against the Bob Baffert horses. Timberlake, we talked about. Track Phantom, we talked about. Tuscan Gold.
Yeah, you talked about that horse, didn't you?
He's Tuscan Gold is he's a cool horse. So he's gonna, you know, where he goes next is kind of the question for him. That was a maiden winner for Chad Brown. I don't know that we see him next in the Fountain of Youth, but maybe we do. 92-1 on an impressive maiden winner was good. Tuscan Sky, that was the allowance winner for Todd Pletcher we talked about. That was earlier on the undercard at Fairgrounds that won basically the match race.
Okay.
With Louis Saez for Todd Pletcher. Uncle Heavy, 72-1. That was the Withers winner. Now, with the quarantine that came from the herpes outbreak, unfortunately, Uncle Heavy got sent to a farm in Pennsylvania and has only been training himself in a field. This is like speaking to chickens. Hopefully, that quarantine is going to be lifted on Saturday. He can return to parks. He was never going to run in the Gotham. They wanted to stay on the mile and eighth distance. So we'll see him next in the wood. But certainly, look, he ran a good race. His sire, Social Inclusion, was a Preakness horse, you know, a couple years back. He's certainly an interesting prospect at 72-1. West Saratoga, you know, that was the dream story for Larry DeMerity. He won the two-year-old stake race, came back, didn't run bad, ran okay in the Sam F. Davis, but apparently none of the gamblers liked the Sam F. Davis because all those races, a gate road or a gate whatever was 37-1, but the winner and third place finisher West Saratoga both 99-1. So I guess that race was taken with a grain of salt. But that's kind of the future field where we sit. But I'm still sticking with my top pick, and I will be on a mountain on this one because I promise you there won't be another Patreon show and there won't be another podcast on YouTube that will have a claim victor as their top Derby horse right now. But I'm going down with the ship.
I love it, and claim victor is the horse that's not on that list. So
nope.
Just nope. The touches, but not a claim victor.
Hasn't even won a race yet.
Hasn't won a race yet. Yeah. Yeah.
I think he's going to win the Kentucky Derby in 11 weeks or whatever it is.
All right. And again, we don't know when he's going to race again yet.
No.
Okay.
Soon. For my sake, I'm on this ledge, I'm hoping soon.
Sooner the better. Who trains him?
Todd Pletcher.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's been there once or twice before.
Just a couple times. All right, so that's a really good start for us to round out the early Kentucky, even though it's not early anymore, but the Kentucky Derby contenders to keep an eye on. We'll definitely do a lot more of this once Chad gets back into the States in a couple of weeks. Next week, one more show over in Dubai, and then he'll be home and we'll be all together again. So appreciate it because it's been – was that a cat, by the way, in the background? It sounded like a cat was in heat or something.
We have some cats, we have some birds. Believe it or not, we have some elephants and giraffes out here too. It's
not boring.
That's anyone for sure. anyone who hasn't been here, I would highly recommend it. At least coming one time. It's a special place. It has a very special place in my heart, and you know I've been blessed to work for some good people out here, and thankful for the opportunities. And you know, hopefully we can just keep this ride going.
Yeah, matter of fact, and we'll be talking real soon too about when to ship me up to see you sometime in the summer.
Yes, sir.
I'm trying to think of doing it like maybe right around, take a chance where I could also spend a day over at training camp for the Jets. I haven't done that in a long time. So maybe do a training camp day with the Jets, spend a day with you at the track. So we'll have to figure that out because that would be sometime like around July,
and then spend
August.
A day with the Giants. Listen, the Giants are close to us too. So go to the Jets, come to Saratoga and spend the day with the Giants.
Okay, I could do that. Why not? I know my my good friend Ryan Dunleavy covers the Giants for the New York Post, so I'll just have to make a real nice week of it.
You'll be there. Ryan Dunleavy will be there. Will Saquon Barkley be there? Stay tuned and find out.
Doesn't look like it, but you never know. I mean, I've been talking to all the people I've been talking to. It's like, do you want to spend that much money on a running back? So I don't know.
You know, last year the running back seemed like they had all the leverage in the world, and now I don't know what happened this year, but now no running back has any leverage whatsoever.
No, it's sad too, because that's not the way the sport should be going, but it is. So, but that's another show. All right. Anyway, as always, thanks, Chad. Really appreciate it and your extra time as well. We'll talk to you next week. Talk to everybody next week. Don't forget description area of YouTube. If you're not a Patreon yet member of our show here, please do that. It's only $5 a month. You can't miss. You can cancel. Get your money back? No, but it's only $5. And you have a whole month worth of videos. So check us out on Patreon or, of course, on YouTube. We'll see you guys next time.